The 23rd of September, 1957, 25 years ago tonight, in Hartford, a new television station went on the air. Good evening, I'm Don Lark.
And I'm Barbara Allen.
And this is where it all began 25 years ago tonight. We're on the sixth floor of the Travelers Insurance Company's Central Row building in downtown Hartford.
Back then, these offices were the headquarters of the newborn Channel 3. Then it was known as WTIC-TV. The station was put on the air by the Travelers Insurance Company, the owner since 1925 of WTIC Radio.
As the sister station of WTIC, Channel 3 was the beneficiary of a fine broadcast heritage. WTIC was, as it is today, the most powerful radio station in Connecticut, the owner of a proud reputation as one of the industry's giants.
But even with WTIC's fine record, the Travelers had to engage in a seven-year-long competition with other companies for the Channel 3 license. The station was signed on the air by Paul Morenci, WTIC's general manager for more than a quarter century. The gala opening ended with a minute's worth of the day's news on slides.
Channel 3 remained the property of the Travelers Insurance Company until it was sold in 1974 to the Washington Post Company, which is the station's owner today.
WFSB, as the station has been known since 1974, continued to grow and prosper under the new owners, providing the Channel 3 audience with the kind of entertainment, news, and public affairs programming it had come to demand.
We will take a look at some of the news and public affairs programs you've witnessed as Channel 3 viewers during the past 25 years when we come back.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I have just had the honor and privilege of signing on the air for the first time Connecticut's newest television station, WTIC-TV, on Channel 3.
Chickaberry, and of course, the mayor of our town, Hap Richards.
Well, hiya, kids, and a happy start of a new day to all of you.
Okay, so what do we do now?
It's time for the Ranger Andy Show.
My name is Ranger Andy, and I've traveled all around. And I am writing you a song about the things I've found. I'll sing about the mysteries of animals galore, and hope to tell you many things you never knew before. Come along, sing the song. On the chorus we will sing it loud and strong. I hope that you'll enjoy it with your family and your friends, and sing with me the longest song, the song that never ends.
Hi friends, welcome to the Ranger Station.
Hi everyone, how are you? You know, my name is Captain Bob.
Hi Machine.
Boy, have I missed you.
Boy, I missed you too, Machine. Hey, Machine, let's start the show.
That's a great idea, Marlo.
Welcome to the world of Marlo and the Magic Movie Machine.
I am Marlo.
Are you feeling lucky? Yeah! Then let's play double play.
Hi, I'm Hilton Catterly.
And I'm Susan Lichtman.
And we are live at the Old State House in downtown Hartford.
And we welcome you to the Songs of Christmas.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King.
The
Songs of Christmas with Hilton Caddley and Susan Lichtman.
New England has a spirit and feeling all its own, and we'll capture part of that Yankee pride with PM Magazine's New England Festival next.
You know, I wasn't even born when some of those shows first started.
Neither was I. Well, I was only a couple of years old. We grew up with television and watched technology change the way shows look.
Today, we videotape our shows and broadcast them a few days later. But a quarter of a century ago, just about everything on television was live, including TV3's first entertainment show.
It was called What in the World and was hosted by John Dando.
You can interrupt me if you have the answer as I read the directions for the question. What do the following have in common? Bear, treacle, wicked, vinegar, September, bug.
Hi, I'm Dave Smith, Channel 3 Sports. Keeping an eye here on the Whalers who begin their season in a couple of weeks. You know, sports have played a rather large role in the history of this television station. For years, you've seen the Greater Hartford Open on network television, but way back when, Channel 3 did the Greater Hartford Open live to Southern New England, back when it was the Insurance City Open. Channel 3 also broadcast the Yale-Harvard Regatta. That was a long time ago. We even had a camera live in a helicopter. It's commonplace today, but it sure wasn't back then. Our crack engineers got the picture back from New London to Hartford and out to your homes.
Good evening, everybody. This is Brad Davis at the New Haven Railroad Bridge over the Thames River in New London, Connecticut. This is the starting line for the rowing of the Harvard-Yale varsity race, which is scheduled to get underway within 15 minutes. The four-mile race will be upstream this year. The weather has been beautiful for the past hour. The course is just like glass. It's an extremely fine course tonight.
Great moments for you on TV3.
Back in 1957, our dreams would come alive. Year by year, we kept on growing. Year by year, till 25.
Great moments.
What you're after?
Great moments.
Lots of laughter.
Great moments. For you on TV3.
Moments we've gone through together. Seems they've gone so fast. Our silver celebration says that thanks to you.
We're the very best.
Great moments. TV3, great moments,
every day now,
great moments,
here to stay now,
great moments, for you on TV3.
Hey, is the tape rolling?
Okay.
Hey, you remember before GAN, we were going on, what, the 16th of May, was it, Lee?
Yes.
16th of May, and the day before, remember they brought the whole group in, Dick, and said, we're going through a dress rehearsal, so the cameramen get a chance to run this. They haven't done anything but drive a car, you know? So they were going to do a run-through, a cold run-through on the show, and let the guys get a chance to use the cameras. And I remember they put us out on the air, just the video part. We didn't know this. They put us out. No audio, just video. And they started getting phone calls. Put the audio on. And we didn't know anything about it. We got a letter from a guy down in Yarmouth, Nova Scotia, was picking it up.
Welcome, neighbors, to the Big Ken McKenzie Show. Yes, here they are, all your favorite country western music stars. Your host, old Happy Smiling himself, why none other than Ken McKenzie.
me with you. Yes, sir.
WNBC Channel 30.
Yes, television is a very exciting medium, and it takes a pretty large family to keep our home running right. All of us here at WNBC were really happy we could meet with you and chat for a while about what we're doing. We hope the next time you turn on your television set and allow our family of performers to visit with you, you'll feel that both families have become closer friends.
Good evening, everyone. The United States launched another satellite this afternoon, but it's still not known whether it is in orbit. President Eisenhower told his news press conference that Russia has suggested holding an east-west conference in the United States. He said that if the summit talks can be arranged, and if they are lengthy, he'd be in favor of holding them in this country. The president also defended his disability agreement with Vice President Nixon. He said Nixon never was acting president during his three major illnesses, but that he would have done so if necessary.
Hello, I'm Harvey Olson. As Channel 30 News Director, I have two special interests. One, in what news events happen daily. Two, seeing that you find out what happens too. For this purpose, I depend in part on two top-notch cameraman reporters, Bill Mill and Joe Calvi, both ready to go to the scene of events. The news that's gathered by this and other means is presented on Channel 30 News three times each weekday and twice on the weekend. Barry Barrons prepares and presents the news at 1:55 Monday through Wednesday and weekday evenings at 7 and 11. Mark Jennings handles the Thursday and Friday afternoon news as well as a Sunday night newscast, while Al Kennedy takes the Saturday night news following Saturday night at the movies. This, then, is part of the makeup of Channel 30 News, our effort towards keeping you informed. When you look for news, look to Channel 30 News.
Torrents of water fell. Rivers rose and rushed and leaped out of their banks. Connecticut's worst disaster was upon us.
You can have no conception of what has happened until you come here and listen to these governors. What has happened in each state? Industries flattened. Cities practically paralyzed. Communications halted. People out of work, suffering.
At 10 o'clock on the night of August 24th, 5 days after the flood had hit, the WKNB Flood Telethon went on the air from the studios in West Hartford, presenting the biggest array of top-flight entertainment artists ever assembled on a single television program. Yes, the money rolled in, and when the final count was taken, WKNB had nearly $250,000.
Our regularly scheduled program will not be seen at this time, so we can bring you the following News 40's special presentation. A trip down memory lane through the archives of Channel 40. At 40 years.
Good evening and welcome to our 40th anniversary show. I'm Ray Herschel. Dave, this is going to be a trip down memory lane. It's going to be a lot of fun, I think.
Really, that's only a sampling of what you're going to see here tonight as 40 celebrates 40 years. And Ray, I think the best place to start is where we do it all today, right in our news studio.
Okay, this is where it happens on a daily basis. And, of course, we're going to take you back 40 years. In addition to that, we're going to be taking you to really the studio where it all began here at Channel 40 40 years ago as well.
This is the newest part of the building here at Liberty Street. But over here are some of the new additions. This is the newest addition to our news set. This is the News 40 Weather Center, where Ed Carroll, Paul Sutton, and Bruce Avery, and Roger LaPlante do all of their work. It got really broken in during the blizzard in 93, didn't it?
It sure did. You talk about new technology. That's only been in operation now just a few weeks as well.
It sure has been.
And as we stroll down through the middle studio here, a little bit of memorabilia on the walls and everything, but this is where Dan York does his show, Dan's Desk, without chairs. Actually, this is about the most quiet you'll see this set, as you can imagine.
No, this way you used to do the news, too, before, wasn't it, Ray? Now, over here, these are the News 40 lockers, and this my friends, has not been open for 30 years. This is Bozo's Locker. And like they opened Al Capone's vault, maybe before the night is out, we will open Bozo's locker. And we have found some Bozo memorabilia around here. And I think, Ray, there's probably some smelly shoes in there, too, somewhere. But
That has been locked ever since Bozo left the station about 30-odd years ago.
30-odd years ago. And odd years they were.
Yeah, and let's see if we can find a key before we go off the air here. But this is the studio literally where it all began. Mm-hmm. And as we pan over, part of this hour is going to be exciting because we've got a lot of history we're going to show you. We've also got some of the people who've made this station a success over the years in our studio live. And there you get a shot of some of them as we're panning over. My goodness. Some of those people go back to my era. Some of those people, believe it or not, were here before I started at Channel 40 back in April of 1968. As a matter of fact, this month, I'm celebrating my 25th anniversary here at Channel 40 as well.
Everybody's sitting around the TV, waiting for something to happen. When it finally did, this is what they saw. WHYN Channel 55. Charlie DeRose was the original owner of the station. Vic Pelcher was one of DeRose's first employees. We asked Vic to talk about those early days on Mount Tom.
Up on a mountain, he had three sets together. We had the news, sports, and the weather. So between the weather and news, he had about a minute commercial. So you just swing the camera around and boom, you're ready for the weather. And when the weather was all done, you had another minute to get the sports.
Of course, things have changed a great deal since those early days. Today's set is state-of-the-art, with three cameras ready to move wherever they need to go. In October of 1957, Channel 55 became Channel 40, and with the move came more power. WHYN-TV could now be seen as far away as Greenfield. What Western Mass was watching was everything from news to the Admiral and Swabby.
Admiral and Swabby show, which is probably the one program or the one participation in the broadcasting business that will always be paramount in my mind and perhaps the thing that I'll be most remembered by back home in Springfield. It was a wonderful experience for 7 years, an interesting experience. Started out as the Admiral show, as a wraparound for the Popeye cartoons. And the fellow who was directing the show, Norm Goyer at the time, had an idea of how we could expand it and come up with a concept of where the Admiral was always the good guy and the character which he portrayed himself, the Swabby, would be the mischievous sailor, always trying to get away with something on the Admiral, but always getting caught, having that subtle message for children that good behavior is always the best and what pays the most.
It's interesting how that whole thing came about. I was directing the Admiral and Swabby show, and they introduced a new character called Swabby. The program director at the station, name was Murray Tesser, I believe, was an ex-vaudevillian, and he was to take the part of Swabby. I was directing it, and I gave him such a hard time one day about how I wanted him to do the part that he took his sailor suit, threw it down, and said, "Okay, wise guy, you do it." And 10 years later, I was still doing the show.
So we had some wonderful experiences and did some great things, had some interesting characters go through that show, and it was the highest-rated local show in Western Massachusetts at the time. And from what I understand, the ratings have not been equaled since that time, and that, of course, is quite an honor and something to be proud of.
To this day, I'm out doing an air show someplace, and somebody will come up to me and say, "Hey, Norm, didn't you used to do the Swabby Show years ago?" I said, "I sure did." And they say, I sat in your lap back then.
For a number of years, I wrote and helped write and produce and played the character of Bozo the Clown. I don't know if I'll ever live that down or not, but we had a lot of fun with that, and we did many, many hundreds of hours of live television, and I think we made a lot of people happy and had a lot of fun doing it. I think back of all the memories of television, and I have to say that it was a lot of fun, and it was a great education. You couldn't possibly get the same type of education today simply because of the way the world has changed.
Now, here is your host, Frank Knight.
And no Channel 5 story would be complete without New England's number one television news.
Now, Tom Ellis, Chet Curtis, Natalie Jacobson, meteorologist Dick Albert, and Don Gillis with sports. This is News Center 5.
It's immediate. It's experienced. It's run morning, noon, and night by people who love their jobs and know themselves. It's a big people's world out there. But we at Channel 5 take pleasure in the little things too.
Brothers and sisters, laughing and growing. Brothers and sisters, things you'll be knowing.
Of course, things didn't always go so smoothly.
Us, you know, I've known about you guys for a long time and seen your videos and stuff, and kind of thought, I wonder what they're like. Aren't you just nice folks? Nice folks who just blow things up. Well, listen, it's a pleasure seeing you once again. Thank you, Wendy. Sweetheart, you're sneaky. See you, Richie.
Okay, cool.
See you, Wendy. You look terrific.
Just put your head right in there.
Like this? Show me how you really do it. All right. Okay, now I've seen a lot of dirty dishes in my time. I've seen a lot of segments go down the drain. I've seen a lot of careers get.
How do you figure what question you're going to ask the players?
Well, I depend. It.
Programming, specials, live events, news and public affairs, all about New England. Channel 5 was ready for its biggest challenge ever, a full-length feature motion picture written, produced, and filmed entirely in New England, the first project of its kind ever undertaken by a local television station, the superb and moving Summer Solstice, starring Henry Fonda and Myrna Loy.
You need a lover.
I have a lover. He just doesn't know how to open a bottle of wine.
It's been a great 10 years. There have been a lot of changes, but some things will never change. As 5 goes on 10, we'll continue to chronicle our world, monitor our health, use our smarts, and be close up with our audience. We've accomplished much, but we haven't forgotten where we came from.
Do it!
Tuning in. Together, Channel 5 and you.
Tuning in.
Together, knowing what to do.
You're tuning in to us, we're tuning in to you.
Tuning in each day, we're New England, all the way.
All the way, New England. Tuning in. Together, Channel 5 and you. Together, Channel 5 and you. Tuning in. Tuning in together. Channel 5 and you, you're tuning in to us, we're tuning in to you. Tuning in together, Channel 5 and you, you're tuning in to us, we're New England, all the way, New England. Tuning in together, Channel 5 and you.